Welcome to this week's Chinuch Hashkafa message. It's Parshas Netzavim, and it's also before Rosh Hashanah. And today I wanted to focus a little bit on Rosh Hashanah, and then we're going to take a break for a few weeks and start again after the Yomim Tovim in Mirz Hashem. So there's just so much to talk about and so much to discuss from Hashkafa point of view when it comes to Rosh Hashanah, and I'm just going to touch on a few points today. Firstly, I wanted to share a vort, which is a vort from the Sfas Emes in the name of his grandfather, Chedusha Harim. And I think it's a nice Dvar Torah to share with children, but it's also a nice perspective to bring out. Obviously, on Rosh Hashanah, we have these two things come together. It's been discussed many places. We have this idea that on the one hand, we are Mamlich Hashem as a king. We totally give ourselves over to Hashem. It's a day of tshuva. It's a day of commitment. It's a day of really showing our commitment and return to HaKadosh Baruch Hu. On the other hand, we know that it's a day of tremendous bakoshes. We keep on asking for things. Avinu Malkeinu and Shemon Esra, Zorcheinu L'chaim, and so on. We ask for so many things that we need, and everyone needs different things in their particular context. So we know that on Rosh Hashanah night, we eat those special foods called simonim, because as the Gemara said, simona milsahi, a simon, a code, a symbol, means something, and therefore we eat the things that represent bracha. But what we eat, those foods are called simonim. Simonim is like a simon, a code. It's not the thing itself, it represents the thing. So we eat an apple and honey, it represents the sweetness. We eat the head, it represents the head, and so on. So you ask the question, why do we need to have simonim? Why don't we just talk about it explicitly and clearly? And he says that the reason that we eat simonim is also to remind us that the gashmias, the physical things that we ask for on Rosh Hashanah, and which we have emun and bitachon that Hashem will give it to us. And of course, every yid should be benched with revealed good, with toiv hanirah v'hanigla. And that is what Hashem is going to do for us. He's going to fulfill all our requests. But at the same time, we need to remember, and we need to try and commit, that the gashmias that we get, and the brachas that we get, which are physical blessings, should only be a simon. It's not an end in itself. The physical things that we ask for is not for the things themselves, it's for them to be a simon, for them to be a code, so to speak, for a higher purpose, to serve the Eibishter, to bring the Eibishter into the world, to elevate the physical things. So yes, of course on Rosh Hashanah we daven for all the things that we need, but we also remember that it's just simonim, they're just codes, and we commit and we try as much as we can to give ourselves over to Hashem and Rosh Hashanah, and to say to Him that we're asking for all these things, but we're going to try and use them properly. We're going to try and use them for Avodas Hashem. And that's a very important Hashkafa Yesod foundation to discuss with children as well, of the purpose of Gashmias, the purpose of the physical world, the purpose of the physical things that we have. Not that we should be completely immersed and completely focused on the concept of Gashmias, but really our focus is Avodas Hashem. Of course we need the Gashmias, and of course we ask for it, and we ask for revealed good, but we also ask for it because we want to use it to serve Hashem properly. It's an important foundation. It's an interesting Dvar Torah to discuss with our children as well. But the second thing I wanted to just focus on a little bit is just preparing children before and of course on Rosh Hashanah about what the avir, what the atmosphere of Rosh Hashanah should look like and should feel like. It's both what we discuss with our children, but also what we do to create that culture, because we know that on Rosh Hashanah there are two opposite sort of things coming together, and they're not really opposite. On the one hand, there's no question that Rosh Hashanah is a serious day. It's why we call it Rosh Hashanah, the head of the year. As we know, not Chilas Hashanah, not the beginning of the year, because just like the head impacts the whole body, whatever we do in Rosh Hashanah impacts the entire year. And therefore, that's one of the things we need to prepare our children and prepare ourselves, really, about how not to waste time on Rosh Hashanah, how to use Rosh Hashanah in a more serious way. As the Pasuk says, Gilu Biru Oda, rejoice but with trembling. In other words, a more reserved simcha. It's Yontif, but a more reserved simcha. The idea of serious in davening, the idea of being a serious day. Stories of how tzaddikim and chassidim and great people spent Rosh Hashanah. I remember I personally had a great uncle, his name was Reb Shmaryo Gerari from Eretz Yisrael, and he never spoke a whole Rosh Hashanah, 48 hours he never spoke. I once spent a yontif meal with him on Rosh Hashanah, and he was not convert, he didn't say anything. Because only tilim and davening and learning, and that was it, that was whole Rosh Hashanah. That whole sort of culture, and that Rosh Hashanah were a bit more serious, there's a bit more of a sense of urgency. because we know that it impacts the whole year, and therefore we say a lot of Tehillim. And that's something to prepare children. That's something, obviously, to show an example, to make sure that we're just not sitting on the table socializing and talking and schmoozing and so on. But of course, it's a bit more focused. But at the same time, there's the concept of simcha. We know the famous pasuk that Nehemiah told the Yidden that they shouldn't be sad. They should go home, ichlu mashmanim, shatu mamtakim, to eat good food. And like the tour, the famous tour says that the Yidden bathe them, take a haircut before Rosh Hashanah, because we are so certain that Hashem will perform a miracle for us and bench us with all the good things. So that concept of bitachon, the concept of emunah, of course, we need to do what we need to do. It's a serious day and we do everything we can. But at the same time, discussing the concept of emunah and bitachon, and that when Hashem asks us to daven to Him for all the things that we want, we trust in Hashem that He will give it to us. We have complete emunah. We give ourselves over to Hashem to the point that we celebrate it as a yontif. We have a festive meal. We sing at the end of davening, Hayom Tam Seinu, Hayom Tavarcheinu, because Hashem is blessing us, Hashem is strengthening us. And that combination of, it's a serious day, we take it very seriously, the davening, the tilim, not to waste time, but at the same time, that emunah and bitochen, which comes with a simcha, and a simcha that the fact that the Eibishter is close to us and is becoming our king again, and that there's a tremendous closeness between Hashem and the Bnei Yisrael during the Aseres Mitzvah, all of those things give a feeling of confidence, a feeling of hope, a feeling of simcha. And those two things need to come together. And it's us as parents who need to demonstrate to our children how they come together with ourselves. Think about what we're going to do a whole Rosh Hashanah. Think about what we can plan for our children, give them a challenge of how much tilim they can say, so that the Rosh Hashanah has the right avir, both in the seriousness and in the bitochen and the munna and the simcha that all come together on Rosh Hashanah. I want to just wish everyone that's been listening and everyone just a ksiv vachsim ha-toyva, a good gibench to yar, taka b'toyv ha-nira v'ha-nigla, shana toyva mesuka, and we should have nachas from our children and be able to be mechanach them properly, b'derech Hashem, and together with all the brachas that HaKadosh Baruch Hu will give us, of course, we hope that this year will be the shnas ge'ula, the ultimate bracha of Geul Bias Mashiach Tzidkenu. A good year and a gibench to year.